हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 10 आईसीएसई फाउंडेशन मैथमेटिक्स बाय आर एस अग्रवाल, गोयल ब्रदर्स पब्लिकेशन। वी आर विद चैप्टर्स मेजर्स ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी एंड वी आर डूइंग मीन। दिस इज द एपिसोड 9.9.1 एंड वी आर विद सम नंबर 24। सो आंसर 24, वेट ऑफ 60 एग्स, दैट मीन्स सिग्मा एफ आई इज गिवन। हाउ मेनी एग्स आर देर? 60 एग्स आर देर। कैलकुलेट द मीन। Weight is given 75, 79, 80, 84. That means there is no continuous frequency between 79 and 80. So we have to write down the class interval with the continuous class interval. So 75 and 79, then 80, 84, 85, 89, 90, 94. So we require to have a continuous one. So what we do, we subtract 0.5 from the lower limit and add 0.5 in the upper limit. So here it becomes 74.5 79.5 79.5, and here becomes 84.5 84.5 89.5 89.5 94.5 94.5 99.5 99.5 104.5 104.5, and comes 109.5, and we write here frequency. Frequency is given as what? Here 4, 9, 13, 17, 12, 3 and 2. So this is the frequency given. What do I require? I require class marks. So class marks XI, 74.5 plus 79.5 divided by 2, you get 77, 82, 87, 92, 97, 102 and 107. So these are the class marks. Now what we require? We require to have FIXI. I can use any method over here, but I find this one is easiest. 77 multiplied by 4, 308. I have already multiplied and just have written on the paper, so I'm just writing direct values. 738 1131 1564 1164, then 306 and 214. Now if you add this one, sigma FIXI, you get 5425, while frequency sigma FI is already given as 60. Then we place this one in a formula, sigma FIXI upon sigma FI is equal to 5425 upon 60. That comes up to what? 90.42 grams. This is my mean weight. And make a box. So that is the answer. 90.42 gram is our mean. This is our answer. So this is how you do the sum. I hope you understood. Let us move on to sum number 25. Sum number 25. So answer 25. What is given? The following table gives the marks scored by a student in an examination. Calculate the mean. So it is given marks less than 5, less than 10, less than 15, up till less than 40, and the number of students are given. So what we are going to do, we are going to write down the first of all class interval. So class interval, then we'll write down, after class interval we definitely we require class marks, and next to class marks we are going to go for FI, that is our frequency, and then we can solve the sum. Okay, here 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30, 30 to 35, and 35 to 40. XI means class marks. 0 plus 5 divided by 2, that is 2.5 7.5 12.5 17.5 22.5, 27.5, 32.5, and 37.5. We know class marks 22.5, 7.5. So the difference between them will give us class length, that is what, of 5, because I am going to use step deviation method. So step deviation method is what? X bar is equal to A plus C multiplied by sigma Fi Ui upon sigma Fi. So this is the step deviation method where you require to have class length, that is C, and Ui. So here you have Ui. So Ui is equal to what? Xi minus A upon C. And afterwards you require to have Fi Ui. So frequency is given as what? Frequency is given as 3, 10, 25, 49, 65, 73, 78, and 80. Then Ui, we select Ui assuming as 17.5. So this is our A. So for that one, the Ui will be what? 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This will be 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here Fi Ui. So this one, minus 9, minus 20, minus 25. Here 0, here 65, here 146, here 234, and here 320. If you add so here sigma Fi will be 383, it is 383, not 84, and sigma Fi Ui will be 711. Now placing them there in the value, so X bar, what is our mean? Assume mean 17.5 plus class length is 5 multiplied by 711 upon 383. So what you get here? 17.5 plus, if you solve this one, you get 9.28, that is coming up to how much? 26.78. So this is our, I hope you understood this sum. It is pretty simple. I hope you enjoyed the whole session. Thanks very much, guys. Try to work it hard. Try to do the sums 2-3 times, then you will able to understand. In board examination, these type of sums are about like 3-4 marks. So please work it out nicely. Thanks very much, guys, and thanks for your patience.